Pamobarma is being implemented in the northern region of Ghana, and recently the savannah regions and the northeast, and also the upper east region. The project is targeting livestock herders, crop farmers, traditional authorities, and local authorities. And by local authorities here, I mean MMDAs.
We, the Fulani, we think that we are neglected in the before I came here. I don't know that government or even a non-governmental organization, they are there thinking about us.
Looking at Bupi in particular, livestock production is one of the livelihoods that the people of Bupi lives or depends on. In every Monday, which is a market day in Bupi traditional area, you go to the market and you see the number of youth that are dealing with livestock. It will be marvelous to you yourself.
Kind of need this education because the herders in Bupi here are more, and then we also as community members, we also depend somehow on them.
We are privileged to have a GDCA, an NGO with a program, Pamobarma, which is a livestock program that is coming into our district. And as a district, we are very happy and privileged that we have such an opportunity in our district. Because in our district, we have a chunk of herders who are in the district, and that this knowledge will be beneficial to them because their knowledge in livestock rearing from the production stage to the market will be enhanced.
I came here, I learned a lot of things. That is, I only know practical in the previous time because I am a herder. Before I begin to rear cattle, I don't know the years. I just found myself rearing cattle. But I don't know that there is a lot of things I supposed to know about my animal in the aspect of treating them, in the aspect of where I was supposed to live. And then this has come to the point that we Fulani had been one government or the community to come to the point that we, our own mind correspond with their own mind. That is in the aspect of problems sometimes used to happen. You may see a conflict will come. We don't even know that it's a very simple thing that we have to do to solve all these problems.
As part of the process, we have had a 1 week capacity building session, what we call the informed debate. We call it informed debate because we bring together stakeholders who have some background one way or the other in livestock, be they traders, crop farmers, or people in the government cycles like the veterinary services, the agri department, and also stakeholders from the security services. Talk of immigration, police, and custom, because in one way or the other, they all have some bearing on the livestock trade. And this blend of project participants or workshop participants is important because we need the collective interest and collective expertise of these people, so that as they come together, they are able to identify their individual roles and how their roles interlink to make the livestock sector successful.
In recent issues, you hear there's a clash between herders and community members, clash between herders. These are all related to lack of community entering or lack of negotiation. With this workshop, there are a lot of herders who are here who are coming from different herds associations. And they will go and also educate their people as to how they will be negotiating with the landowners when they want to use their pastures or when they want to use their water bodies. And this will not even cause problems again. More to the point, the Pamobarma and the GDCA did a very marvelous work for Central Gonja, which is still undergoing. They are creating a very big and lucrative market center for the kra market in Bupi here.
Whatever knowledge we are acquiring here, if there is no modern market for the livestock to be sold, the business for employing people will not be achieved to its totality. the market is going to be a modern market that is going to be established. And our traditional authority, General Paul II, has provided 6 acres of land for this market. So you can see that the chiefs and people are very happy and very grateful for the program coming in. That is why they have willingly released the land. And as an assembly, we need to do the documentation so that it will be legal. When it is constructed, more people are going to be employed in terms of the animal chain trade. There will be security. Assembly will mobilize their revenue very well to enhance development in the district. So that is the way it is going to enhance our revenue generation. So the assembly is very happy, and we are not joking with that project.
So as a program, we continue to extend working a hand of friendship to all stakeholders who have interest in the livestock sector, especially stakeholders who are interested in seeing a sector devoid of conflicts and acrimony, so that everybody has the space in order to give up their best, so that in the end, we're able to harness the full potential in the sector as a country. Because Ghana, being a coastal country, and especially in the midst of climate change, herders will continue, and I want to stress that herders will continue to stream into our territories from the Sahelian areas, because access to key resources such as water and pasture is becoming increasingly difficult. And we are fortunate that in our environment, we still have a lot of this. So what we can only do is to put our house in order by way of putting in the necessary infrastructure, by way of securing movement corridors to facilitate their easy movement, so that we are able to achieve mutual benefit, because there's a lot of gain in their coming here. One, we get to improve our local breeds. We get to trade with them. And being a signatory of the ECOWAS protocol, it is mandatory on Ghana as a country to put our house in order so that we will continue to live in harmony with all those who come into our territory, so that at the end of the day, we stay together as peaceful as we have always been, and also to benefit from one another.